Hi YouTube. Looks like it's time for another animated avatar video, because I love those things. I actually have a few more lined up, but I still have to figure them out. Also, sorry about the Toonify local install video. I realized that it was super problematic, but someone recently came out with a Windows fix. However, it requires 50 to 70 gigs of stuff, which is probably not acceptable for most people, so I don't think I'm doing that one. I also have a video already on how to create an avatar using TPSM, which is Thin Plate Spline Motion Modeling, which is not as easy as, you know, one-click solution, but you could do it, and it's pretty cool. If you ever watched a YouTuber, Nerdy Rodent, he uses the TPSM for all his videos. In the bottom corner, you can see an avatar. He also uses the technique that I use to upscale the videos because the TPSM produces a 256 by 256, which is pretty low quality. So I would recommend checking out my upscaling video too to perfect that avatar for free using TPSM. I have some better ideas for generating a free avatar using deepfake and Unreal 5 MetaHuman, but I gotta do some research for that, so it's not coming anytime soon. But in the meantime, let's take a look at this one. Take it away, Avatar.
Hello there, my AI enthusiasts. I'm now veering away from AI art for a second to take a look at other amazing tools to blow your mind. What you're looking at now is an animated avatar. This picture is from the Midjourney community feed. I used in one of my recent videos comparing Midjourney to two other free alternatives. I liked pictures so much, I decided to animate it. The voice you're hearing now was made with voice AI. Check out my video description if you want to learn more about voice cloning.
All right, that was pretty good. Let's see how we did that and also go over the pricing to see how much it would cost. So I used the trial version, so I didn't pay anything yet. Now let's take a look at their pricing models, and they vary greatly. So there's a huge difference between it, not just the price. And you'll see here that the prices go from $5.99 to $50 per month. So that's pretty huge jump. Then it goes from $50 to $300, well, $2.99, one penny. Take that penny and keep it. I'm rounding it off, $300. So I'm not gonna go over the advance and the enterprise plan, because that's more of something, if you were into that, you probably have to read all the fine print, because that's a significant investment. I want to compare the trial, the light, and the pro, because that's probably more likely for the beginner users, people who are getting used to this software. I doubt anyone would jump right into the advanced and enterprise plan, right? So right off the bat, the difference between the trial, it's pretty significant. You know, you only get the 14 days, and so this is not something that renews monthly. You get 14 days and that's it. But as per minutes, it's actually pretty generous. You get 5 minutes, in the light plan you get 10, in the pro you get 15, with the caveat that the trial version does not renew at the end of the month, so you just get 14 days. And something to keep in mind here is that the pro version actually gets rid of the watermark and allows you to have commercial use. So if you're actually going to try to make money out of this, definitely the pro plan is like your only option. The light and the trial, you can forget about it. And it also has the premium presenters, which the light version doesn't have. The light version only comes with the standard presenters. And the funny thing is that the trial version actually has premium and standard presenters. And I see what they're doing there. They're giving you a taste of what, you know, the premium presenters are like. And in the light version, they take it away because you're already a paying customer. You're just not paying enough. So makes sense. And another significant difference with the light version is that you have API access. So if you're doing some of that development and trying to run this through a mobile app or some sort of other thing where you're going to try to make money, you can do the testing, but you actually can't use it for commercial use. If you see here, the pro version is what you're going to need, but for testing, you can do that with the light version. And just know with the light version, you're still going to have the watermark and standard presenters, but you do get 100 AI presentation prompts, and all of them get AI script generation. And if you scroll down just a little bit, you'll see that it goes into more depth with this little chart here that has all the different check marks and compares things side by side. When you first sign up, you'll get a confirmation email. From your email, you can create your first video, and that will bring you right to the creation prompt when you click on that. And then you could just click on create video, and then you can see here the different options. So the first four are ones that I added from Midjourney. Someone else created them, not myself, but I wanted to use them to test this thing because these pictures are so damn nice. But they do have all the presenters down here that you can use. And then I think the HQ is like the high quality premium presenters, and then you got the standard presenters down here. That I noticed with the high quality, it actually has their hands. And if you've seen my Movio video, I mean, this is something, the hands will move as well as the mouth. All right, let's try one of the high quality models, and I'm gonna upload a voice to this model right here, and we're gonna see how the hand movements work. Okay, so I uploaded the voice and I'm gonna generate the HQ video. One thing that's really interesting is that my credits came back, so I got 20 credits left. Okay, let's generate this video. So I'm clicking generate, and then click generate again. So I should have it went to 16 credits. I don't know why, from 18. I don't know, so weird. Okay, so maybe it was just a glitch. So their credit system doesn't refresh as it should, and now I'm down to 14. It said it was gonna use 2 credits from 20, brought me down to 16, and now it's 14. So that's about right though, from after creating these two videos. Let's check out the new one that we created with the hands moving.
One thing that is certain that you might notice that the high quality versions, the hands will move. You can do this with the TPSM thin plate spline motion models as well with the TED Talk models, but you will have to train your samples as the default ones seem quite broken.
All right, he has a British accent. And that's another voice that I got in voice AI. So that's basically my voice being cloned with someone else's voice, or the other way around. I'm cloning someone else's voice over my voice. Now, if you notice at the right here, there's actually a TTS feature, which is text to speech. And you could just basically type in a script, and the voices here are pretty good, but they're nothing too special. So they sound good, but you can get this for free on Clipchamp. And let me just play one here for you to hear what it sounds like.
Hi. This is how I sound like. If you didn't know, you can get all of these.
Hold up, let me try a different voice. Maybe not that one. Let's try Abby.
Hi, this is how I sound like. If you didn't know, you can get all of these voices on Clipchamp, which is a free movie maker on Windows 11, and there is a web-based version as well as a PC install.
All right, let's try Libby.
Hi, this is how I sound like. If you didn't know, you can get all of these voices.
Bella.
Hi. This is how I sound like. If you didn't know, you can get all of these voices on Clipchamp, which is a free movie maker on.
Hi, this is how I sound like.
Hi, this is how I sound like.
That one's very robotic. Let me see here. Let's try a Filipino voice.
Hi, this is how I sound like. If you didn't know, you can get all of these voices on Clipchamp.
Hi, this is how I sound like. If you didn't know, you can get all of these voices on Clipchamp, which is a free movie maker on Windows Labing Isa, and there is a web.
I love it. Yeah, that's pretty accurate. But yeah, these names are the same names that are in Clipchamp. Blessica is one of the names on there, and Abby. And so these are all people that you can get on Clipchamp. You can actually go into Microsoft Azure and use these voices and actually use it with API. One cool thing you can do that you can't do here and on Clipchamp is you can actually manipulate them to have better control of their feelings and stuff like that. In Clipchamp, you can actually add feelings to it and they could whisper, but in Azure, you can actually really make them kind of have like a personality. But it's complicated. I mean, just navigating that site is a nightmare. So Azure is the worst site I've ever seen. I don't know how Microsoft, who they got to manage that interface, but it's terrible. But I digress. All right, last one. We'll do the full script.
Hi, this is how I sound like. If you didn't know, you can get all of these voices on Clipchamp, which is a free movie maker on Windows 11, and there is a web-based version as well as a PC install.
I actually personally like the voice AI stuff, and you can actually do voice AI for free. And if you want to watch my video on that, it's in the video description. Pretty easy to do as well. And you could give it some personality, no problem. And there's hundreds of different voices that you can use. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to upload a voice audio that I actually recorded earlier, and we're going to use that to animate our avatar. Alrighty, since I'm not using the text-to-speech, I'm going to click on this upload voice audio here. So go ahead and click on that and then click on upload your own voice. And I got a saved clip here, so I'm going to use that. I think this voice matches this face since she's like a strong woman. So let's hear it.
If you like this video at all, or if you learn anything, please consider giving it a thumbs up. And if you're interested, you can check the video description to find out how I cloned this voice and created this animated avatar. You're pretty cool, huh?
All right, that sounds great. So let's go ahead and animate it. So if you look at the top right here, there's something that says generate video. So just click on that, and you got to be careful because you don't get your credits back. So once you use that, that's used up and you only got 5 minutes, right? So let's click on it, generate video. And I also saw something here that says 20 credits. We're going to have to look at what that means in a second here. I'll let you know after I click go. All right, so I click generate and it's doing its thing now. Okay, so let's look at the product. And so all you have to do is press play and let's check it out.
If you like this video at all, or if you learn anything, please consider giving it a thumbs up. And if you're interested, you can check the video description to find out how I cloned this voice and created this animated avatar. You're pretty cool, huh?
It looks pretty cool. And it's like a one click thing. So I just uploaded a clip and then chose an avatar and it made it for me. So that's pretty amazing. All right, so that's all I had today. And I hope you enjoyed and learned something. about DID and how to create this talking avatar with ease. I recommend checking out my other videos as well on TPSM, as well as how to upscale and clean up those videos, because they usually produce a very low quality. So you can do this for free, actually. It's just a pain in the butt. But definitely check those out. They're in robotic voices. Sorry, but that's how I was doing it at the time. I got one last clip for you. Take it away, Avatar.
Rick Sanchez here. I'm gonna read you a few quotes, and you could put in the comments if you recognize one of the quotes and who actually said these quotes. So the first one is, be yourself. Everyone else is already taken. I like that one. That one's pretty good. Next one is, be the change that you wish to see in the world. That was a very famous person. All right, now we accept the love we think we deserve. I think that's very true. Another one is, without music, life would be a mistake. So true. So true there. Next one is, there is only two ways to live your life. One is through nothing is a one is though nothing is a miracle. The other is though everything is a miracle. Next is, yesterday is history. Tomorrow is a mystery. Today is a gift of God, which is why we call it the present. Ah, I get it. Well, it's nice. Next one is, I have not failed. I have just found 10,000 ways that don't work. That won't work. I use that when it worked. All right, next one is, it's never too late to be what you might have been. Ouch. Yeah, very true. Everything you can imagine is real. This guy paid stuff. You might know him. Probably used his name in an AI art prompt. Next one is, life is about finding yourself. Life isn't about finding yourself. Sorry about that. Life is about creating yourself. I like that. Tabula rasa. Do what you can with what you have and where you are. So true. Reach on. And when you want something, all the universe conspires in helping you achieve it. Want money? I haven't got that. See about that. All right, the last one is, you may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us and the world will live as one. Bet you'll never get that one. All right, thanks. Don't forget to like the video.